Session tonight.
Yes.
Are you encouraged?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Very much so. I feel that there's a better understanding of why we did things, and also better, I think it's just a better understanding between council and the commission, what commission's duties are, why we did what we did, and commission's, or the council's looking at the plan and maybe going back and revisiting some items. So I think that's a positive.
What kind of tweaking do you think it'll take on the part of council to get the commission to go along? By the way, does that have just to be a 4-3 vote on the commission, or does it have to be a larger number?
At 4-3, okay. As long as a majority. And we have to have at least 4 for a quorum. So if we've got to even conduct business. And so we would look for a majority, at least 4 votes saying yes.
Okay. Just to easiest clarify way. Your rule, you came from the state of Ohio Auditor's Office, correct?
No, the state of Ohio, the Office of Budget Management.
Okay.
Our director is the statutory chair and voting member on the commissions, on all of the local government commissions. He has the ability to designate someone or someones. I am the one. So I do all the local government commissions, and I also sit as a voting member in all the school fiscal emergency commissions.
Okay. Well, some of it is that you're optimistic that a combination between the tax credit and an income tax proposal and some assessment measures are going to come together and end up being the plan for Massillon?
It sounds like it, yes. It definitely does. Right now, the reduction in the tax credit is an instant boost to the revenues, and that will enable the city to have more time to see if they can pass the income tax levy. It's up to the voters. It's in their hands.